Hello there, John O'Hurley here. Jay Peterman from Seinfeld, and you're listening to the Better Half podcast. You have to choose between happy married, happy single. Good luck. There is no in between.
Hope you weren't offended by last week's beginning of the show.
What do you mean?
Do you not listen back?
No, I listen. I just don't listen on time. What did you do?
Nothing of substance, but I caught the tail end of your conversation you and your wife had as she was storming up the stairs.
I forgot what we
all there was nothing major. I think just a couple love yous, and that was about it.
Fuck. And then a fuck you. Story of my life.
Quarantine life. What episode is this? 72?
Could be. Let's
double check. On the fly.
Oh, yeah, everyone's home.
25, that don't make sense. Oh, 72, yep. All right, everyone, welcome to episode 72 of the Better Half podcast. I'm Larry, and I'm happy being miserable. No, I'm miserable being happy.
Yeah, and I'm Frank, and I'm miserable right now because I'm in quarantine.
We are still in quarantine. Well, we are at least. Not necessarily everyone on my block stays in quarantine, but I'm in quarantine.
I'm in hell.
What? But you're home. Home is where the heart is.
So it's where the hot burn is. I day drank today.
Well, did you really? What time?
Who knew that tequila actually goes with pink lemonade?
Oh, that sounds interesting.
It wasn't bad.
Was the clock still, was the hour still a single digit when you started drinking?
No, 12:30. I'm not a degenerate. I have kids in the house. For
crazy. I don't know. Well, you know, doesn't stop some people.
Yeah, I'm tired.
What was today's lesson? Tired. What was today's school lesson?
Let's see. Joey had a lot of the math, which I helped him with.
Okay.
My son and my daughter had a meltdown over the word whistling.
What?
Because I told her it was an action word, because the magician was whistling.
Okay.
And she thought in her little 10-year-old brain that it meant something else, that it was a metaphor. And I'm like, no, it's not.
A metaphor
for
what? It
is a whistling magician.
I'm trying to think what she... Yeah.
There was a story where she had to basically, finish, it was like a writing prompt.
Okay.
Basically, she had to say, like, oh, the whistling magician was scuba diving and he found a shipwreck.
Okay.
And you had to finish the story. So she thought.
Are you putting her through improv?
No. She's learning lesson, the hard knocks lessons in this fucking house. She's getting wall-to-wall treatment. So banging off that wall. I said, well, maybe the magician was about to surface because he needed to whistle because he's a whistling magician, and he saw a mermaid. She taught him how to whistle underwater, or he saw the shipwreck, and he said, I'm going to learn how to hum because I really want to, look at the shipwreck. I'm like, use your fucking imagination. This went on for 3 hours. 3 hours. I'm wrong. I don't know what I'm talking about. I'm like, then do your fucking homework. I don't care. I don't care.
So, like, do you have to, like, are they, like, legitimate, like, are you now a legitimate homeschool teacher? Like, do you have to submit paperwork or something?
I should be getting pay.
Hazard pay?
Some sort of pay, I should, because...
You are.
I don't even like my kids at this point.
Have you told your kids they're... What?
What? Go ahead.
Have you told your kids they're each getting $500 from the government?
Yes. fuck off. I did tell him to go fuck off. Oh, no, no. I'm not seeing any of that money because I make too much. Oh, my wife makes too much. So
really? Oh, good for you guys.
The body of Keebler Elves. I'm in.
Oh, that is a Chips Ahoy. Is that a Chips Ahoy? Mm-hmm. There is nothing better store brand wise than a Chips Ahoy chocolate chip cookie unless you dip that motherfucker in some milk.
Bro, I have blackberry soda.
That is disgusting to drink soda with cookies. That is disgusting.
Milk's a premium item in this house.
So is toilet paper.
No, I got plenty of toilet paper.
Really?
I had to wait online to get into the supermarket today, so yay, socialism. That was nice.
How, on the level of none to I can come over and start buying rolls from you, how good are you with the toilet paper?
I have plenty.
Okay. I may be running.
I have triple. You can't come over, but
I. I may be running dangerously low. So, I may need to.
One roll? I'll give you two rolls. For your little sweet.
What? Ooh. Ooh, boy. That
you're
may...
you're going to be bothering your ass, aren't you? That's right. Motherfucker.
That... we might have to talk about that.
In essence, I can spare a square.
As my dad said, when he was in boot camp, all he got was two squares. That's it.
I couldn't go like that. I'm taking two ply and I'm splitting them into one ply.
I'm a big one ply person. I don't need fanciness.
Nah, I don't need saw three ply. Like, who needs that crazy kind of knife?
They're selling four ply on Amazon.
Wait, see, if you need three ply, you're rich enough to fucking have someone actually just wipe your ass. Jeeves, wipe my ass.
I'm actually looking into a bidet.
Yeah, because that's a good investment.
It absolutely would be. I wouldn't buy toilet paper anymore.
Okay.
And I get my butt squeaky clean.
Squeaky clean.
Squeaky clean. As I walk, my butt will whistle.
Well, it could whistle from other things, but I'm okay.
Oh. I'm starting to get a little dangerously low on some supplies, but I'm still hanging in there. I'm checking Amazon every day to hopefully put an order in. But then I'm worried it would get confiscated.
Why don't you just put the order in now, get it over with, and then it'll just come someday when you're not expecting it?
Because everything's due in June.
No, I just checked about 2 days ago, and I could get an order coming May 5th.
That was 2 days ago. A lot changes in 2 days.
Well, you should guess what? You would have been June. I now. Did. It's going to probably be July.
I was good to go. I was stacked, ready to go, but I'll have to figure something out.
You know what you could use? Some of your, what do you call it? Some of your memorabilia back there. Wipe your ass.
Hey, there's nothing here worthy. Well, these.
You could keep washing Hulk Hogan's head off.
I can use hot sauce. Yeah, that's the official Trailer Park Boys decent hot sauce.
How come I don't have that?
Because this is a limited edition first batch.
Well, I guess the ante just went up for that toilet paper.
Heat level, 2 of 10.
One little sweet pop and...
I thought you didn't collect these anymore.
One bottle of hot sauce, that will cost you, that will be four rolls.
This is bottle 289. You know what I can use for TP? My remaining two invitations to the party that I was supposed to have this past weekend.
A party.
My big WrestleMania / 40th birthday / live podcast.
Yeah, that got fucking ruined, huh?
Got ruined. Yeah, I was so gung-ho. Let me ask you a question, and I know you probably wouldn't have been able to, but were you going to be try to get that day off?
No.
Which would have been this past Sunday? No. You know, assuming the virus never happened.
No, I couldn't. I put in, I already had, I told you, I couldn't put in for this weekend this past weekend because I put in for next weekend, which is Easter Sunday and my birthday.
Gotcha.
So that got fucked.
You can give those back.
What?
You can give those back.
I'm still going to take off because at least Saturday morning I could get up, hop in my Pontiac, and drive for an hour and a half and not be bothered. Possibly
that
not
is true.
One way. Come back.
I was all ready. I had this, and I figured, you know, when you said you got the job and you're working on Sundays, I knew you wouldn't be able to make it. I was, if you did, we would have done a live Better Half podcast in front of a studio audience because there would have been people there.
Right.
But obviously with everything happening, you know, it's funny when I, you know, I originally had my party booked, as you know, at the VFW hall in Brooklyn. And, you know, as when this was all happening, like the beginning of March, right? Yeah. And, you know, things started to start slowing down and started to kind of, like, the sports, NHL just went suspended, NBA just stopped. So I'm like, oh, I really don't want to put this on hold because I didn't think anything would change at WrestleMania. So then when I called my dad, he had just gotten back from a meeting, and they were talking about the hall. And I'm like, you know, I may have to pull the plug on this party. And all he told me was, He's like, I want to hear you say it. I'm like, what? He's like, I want to hear you say it if you're going to pull the plug on the party.
Okay.
I'm like, why are you making me go through this? But later, I knew, because then it would be my decision, not necessarily the decision made for me.
Correct.
Because basically the VFW were canceling all the parties regardless. But I canceled it on my own accord, so I feel a little better with that. But yeah, too, I was really looking for, I had this whole podcast thing. I was gearing up for a huge podcast, which I would have had you in mind. I would have had Rippo in mind. Chew, I don't know.
Wow. I hope he doesn't listen to this. Oh, wait. No one does.
He does. So. 200 people do.
Correct. It only took about 13 and a half years. What, but we have 200 likes.
What
that
you...
doesn't really mean 200 people listen to it. I mean, 200 likes.
Very true.
I mean, I think all of my Facebook personalities have liked the page.
That's true.
You know?
But
sorry, that was the last of my snack. So.
Yeah, what was that? What was that other thing you had besides the cookies?
It was a coconut covered marshmallow.
That sounds tremendous. Were they warm?
They sell. No, oh. They were just in out of a bag.
Just picked up off the street, randomly.
Yeah.
So instead of doing the live podcast remote from a hall, I actually, and you know what? For what it's worth. And from my mental state, seeing how I was slowly, slowly descending into madness with this whole quarantine, I ended up going, which we will. I ended up going live anyway, both Saturday and Sunday, because the show was actually two nights. And
I could not partake because I was actually beating my children that night.
You know, it's all right because you're not into wrestling, which is fine, but it wouldn't have really worked for people not into wrestling, because my mom joined, actually joins all my live streams, and she's like, I can't see anything. I'm like, what are you talking about? I'm right here. So yeah, I see you, but I don't see WrestleMania. I'm like, I am not streaming WrestleMania. That would be illegal. So she's like, oh, all right, I'll talk to you tomorrow. Because it's really just me. No noise, no sound, just me watching the show and reacting, and other people in the chat room watching the show as well. So, you know.
And then they would be able to comment.
We were commenting, yeah. Where if we had everyone in the room at the hall, obviously everyone would be watching, and I'd be doing my nonsense and antics, and I was gearing up to do a quiz show, kind of, sort of. And I was going to put one of my wrestling belts on the line for someone to actually try and win it from me.
Wow. I think I would have bid on that. Oh.
So,
just because I would have worn it every time I seen you, just to rub it in your face.
So,
but if you really want 12 rolls of toilet paper, there's a certain giant Cheerio that I want.
No, because you're just going to take it and then destroy it.
Yeah. Yeah.
You're going to put it in a big bowl of milk and actually eat the foam.
No, I'm going to just light it on fire.
Oh, terrible.
Or my new fire pit. So
I don't even know where that is. I gotta find that actually. That cost me a lot of money. So you know, I was happy that what became a disaster ended up actually being very successful for me, and I really needed it this weekend. So that was pretty good.
Good.
So I'm happy.
Well, I'm glad you had some positive.
I did.
I, on the other half, my birthday's
it's coming up.
Plans were ruined.
Ruined.
And I don't know when that's going to be made up, but I'm sorry, I'm trying to find our podcast on iTunes.
Yeah, what is going on? Just search the better half.
Yeah, it's not coming up. It just says, it's just blank. I think it's because I haven't been on iTunes and I haven't downloaded the new.
That could be it. You need a new laptop. Doing.
Nothing wrong with this laptop.
How old is it?
4 years old.
How old is it?
4 years old.
Oh, that's it? I thought it was like 9.
No.
Oh, all right.
No, so what? The fan only works sometimes.
You have to wait.
I pick it up, it goes.
You have to wave it in the air to cool it down.
Yeah, I think we still have 10 reviews. I don't know. I can't find them. I don't care.
But listen, you should be... I was going to say, with quarantine, though, you're with your family. I'm sitting here all by myself.
And you're a lucky sumbitch, aren't you? You could be in your underwear right now. Well, you could be Donald Ducking it right now, and I wouldn't know.
I could be. I may have been.
I have to wear pants. So,
let me ask you a question.
I'm home with 2 kids that don't listen. A wife that is giving me 800 million things to do, but won't have sex with me. What else? I play video games almost every other night with my friends because my wife won't have sex with me. My birthday's coming up, so I'm hoping I actually have sex. that would be nice. That should be on the docket. I mean, I think I penciled it in from 3 to 5.
Social distancing.
Yeah, well, I live with these people, so I'm not social distancing. I've been given a list of things to do. Even when I go out, I get a text of things I need to pick up. So, I'm not going back to work till the 13th.
Okay.
So I still have another couple of days home. Okay. No reason other that the post office lied to us and told us one person was sick in my building. And it's actually 6. So,
okay. Well, you know, numbers.
Yeah, none of them directly work near me.
That's good.
But one of them may come in contact with the area that I work in.
Gotcha. So just bring some Purell.
Well, I have a N95 mask, and I have these very thick car hot gloves, which are for workers.
Oh, I know what you're talking about. Yeah.
The old thing, I still, you know, but yeah. Again, you know, I'm in close contact with people in my immediate area. And I really have no problem elbowing some bitch in the face if she comes too close. Like today. What? Today I was online. I was feeling the burn at Ivorone Supermarket. And I was fourth in line to get in because they weren't letting a certain amount of people in.
Okay.
And I turn around and there's this fucking bitch right up on my ass. Like, literally, like a foot away. I'm like, hey, back off. She's like, oh, sorry. I'm like, yeah, social distancing. You might have heard something on the news.
6 feet, lady.
6 feet. I was like, so then I turned around and I was like, crikey. You know, I was like, very, I went inside. I got the 4 things I needed. And then I was like, I get a text. Can you get milk? So I go to the milk aisle and I turn and I'm bending like, you know, into the freezer cooler thing to get milk. And some lady turns her shopping cart and pretty much breaks my hip.
Takes you out for a carton of milk.
I'm sorry, sonny. I didn't see you. I'm like, you'll be dead in a week, lady. And then I went, I coughed on.
Aww. No, that'd be awesome.
But, and then I went to go drop something off at a friend's house. And he stayed inside while I dropped it off. And then... I got in my car and he came outside, so it was like, hey, hi.
Well, you're very, I don't know if we, have we recorded since my birthday? I don't think so. No, because that week would have been the episode dropped.
We already did a Skype episode.
But I'm saying it was before my birthday. So, This was before I can tell everyone, you know, how you just heard Frank say he dropped something off at his friend's house. Frank is like a guardian angel. Like, during this time of need, he's kind of been driving around, dropping things off. So, my birthday was a Monday, March 30th. And yes, it was very, you know, I turned 40. You know, I saw Frank's flashback of his 40th birthday. He had a party. He was surrounded by friends and family. I wasn't there. And, you know, my 40th.
There was no friends there. There was one friend there.
My 40th, I spent on my couch. And, you know, I did FaceTime my parents, which was nice. But, you know, I didn't have anything going on. And then my very good friend, Frank Messina, the co-host of the Better Half podcast, which you can listen to every other Wednesday, texts me. He's like, "Are you home?" I'm like, "Yeah." Now, admittedly, I was actually about to get into the shower when you texted me. So he texts me, and then I don't hear from him. So I'm like, I wonder why he asked me if I was home. And then I texted back. I'm like, "Are you downstairs or something?" And he's like, "Yeah." I'm like, "Oh, okay." So I put clothes on. Because at that point, I was... I couldn't work yet because I couldn't get my home setup going yet. So I just... I mean, God help me, I hadn't showered in weeks. I barely was putting clothes on. I was just ugly. I went downstairs, and Frank was so kind enough, and it really touched my heart, I have to say. Of all the times he could be a complete and utter asshole to me, he really... He really was genuine and bought me this nice little single birthday cake, which was out of this world. So, Frank, I will forever be thankful for that. That really meant a lot to me and did go far with me.
Well, I'm glad you enjoyed it. And I just said, you know, I figured it's got to suck for you. I mean, I know, you know, it's sucking for everybody, but I'm like, all right, you know, Larry's pretty much, you know, alone, stuck in his apartment on his birthday. And I'm like, there's not much I could do. I know his party is ruined, but...
Ruined.
But I said, maybe I could, you know, put a little smile on your face.
It really did.
What better way than some chocolate ganache?
You got to go and get one yourself, honestly. It was so damn good. So damn good. So, yeah, it meant a lot. And I will say this, not in the exact same way, but I will look to reciprocate this weekend very quickly for your birthday. So
don't worry about it. No, please. It's no big deal. I've eaten everything in this fucking house 10 times over already. So I lost 11 pounds since Disney. I think I gained 19. So
I am so sick and tired of seeing healthy people exercise online. Because of this quarantine.
They're all full of shit.
I'd rather see, like, us try and work out online. At least, A, it's meaningful, it should happen, and, you know, it's more genuine than people who make it a lifestyle of working out.
Yeah, those people are insane, you know. Again, not bad to look at, I'm not going to lie.
Oh, no, yeah, not bad. Still insane. So let me ask, you know what, we haven't done this in a while. A sudden interruption, even though you had paused.
Why do I hear kids there?
My window's open.
Oh, you're not like, you know, you didn't like go on a manhunt or something, did you? Like, I'm not like trapped in your bed or something.
No, though the greatest game
is... Some children, I have toys.
The greatest game to hunt is human game. If you did live alone, no kids, no wife.
Oh, it's fantastic already.
Would you even... And we're in the quarantine, and we're in this quarantine era.
Okay.
As I call it, the QE, the quarantine era. Would you even, and you had to work from home and stuff like that, so basically there was no need for you to leave the house, would you even bother stepping foot in the shower?
No. Well, no, that's not true, because I wouldn't shower every day, but like I'd probably do one every like third day, I think.
Would you even pull the...
No, I can tell you right, because... It'd probably be, if I was alone, working from home, at 5 o'clock, after dinner, I'd probably have, like, I'd probably, you know, be masturbating more than often.
Fair enough.
And more than I do now, and, you know, because I have a wife, you know. and whatever. And I would probably, you know, smell myself. I'm like, that's not ripe.
Yeah, so, sometimes. Yeah, it gets rough after a while. All right, how about this? Let me spin this. Say you do take showers on a regular basis to try and keep your sanity. Would you even bother putting on deodorant?
I wouldn't bother putting on pants, let alone deodorant. I mean, if I was doing a conference call, I'd probably throw on a pair of sleep pants just in case I had to get up and my schlong didn't hit the Zoom camera, you know? My biggest problem is I have to keep remembering to take the tape off my little camera eye on my laptop.
Oh, yeah.
So I'm paranoid.
Paranoid much?
The all 200 of our followers.
Yes.
When the vaccine comes out, don't take it.
Really?
Okay. Yes.
But yes. Are you an anti-vaxxer?
I'm not an anti-vaxxer. I'm just an anti-government. And there's going to be things in this vaccination that will potentially do us harm.
Like nanobites or something? Like yes. Little...
Larry, 5G nanobites. 5G's...
Listen, please, I want lightning speed on my phone on the internet. Just plant the tower in the middle of my living room. I'll grow a third head. I'm fine with that.
It says, you have reached 200 page likes. Nice work. Create a post thanking the people who like the page. I'll do that later.
Thank you. All 200 people. I mean, we only got 12 votes on our final, but we got 200 likes.
12 votes, but two of them were ours.
That's right. So get 10. It's not quantity. It's quality.
Well, I guess it's time to announce the
winner. Let's talk about it. So a few weeks ago,
yes,
right before the quarantine, in fact, as I think they were deciding on the quarantine.
PQ.
Yes, pre-quarantine.
No, PQ.
Yeah, pre-quarantine.
Right, you were saying pre-Q.
No, I said pre-quarantine, but you started talking. So all you heard was Q.
Pre-Q, too. Okay,
it's a little bit of a delay.
I'm slowly going insane. Do you understand? I'm slowly going insane.
Slowly? Okay. I think you've hit max speed.
I'm a teacher by day, I'm a father by night, and I have no time for myself. None. Because normally, when I'm home in the morning, my kids would be in fucking school. Okay? And they're not. They're under my feet. I can't watch TV. I can't watch Netflix. I can't do anything. Okay, do you know how many times I've watched an episode on Netflix that had a pause when Joey or my daughter come out of the room because they can't see the adult television? And I had my friend who's coming over to my other television that says, I can't watch TV downstairs because Stephanie's working. And someone has to keep an eye on the kids. And the 40-inch TV that's going into the new playroom, excuse me, new family room, okay, has not been mounted on the wall yet. So I can't even watch Netflix in there because the guy who's going to mount it can't come to my house because of this quarantine.
I mean, everyone has to leave.
No. Yeah, good luck with that.
Now, but this would have been your summer. This is how your summer would have went.
No.
Yeah, because your kids wouldn't have... Oh, okay. For you or for them?
For them, but it's also for me, because then the second I get home, see, I would drop them off at camp, pick up my breakfast, come home, pants off, watch TV, read a book, play video games. I had the world as my oyster. And then until about 2 o'clock, I would get ready and go to work. Mm-hmm. However, on my days off, I would just do nothing.
Oh, yeah, fair enough.
I would do some laundry and dishes and make it look like I did something.
Gotcha.
Then I would do nothing for the rest of the day.
So let's talk about the finals of the March Babeness.
Yes, everybody. We have two winners. No, we have one winner. Two finalists.
Yes. So with a, it was a gut-wrenching tournament. We had some shockers. We had some winners, and we had a whole bunch of losers.
Yes. Loser.
And it basically boiled down to the finalists being adult film star, because we just typecast ourselves.
Star with a child's cherub-like face.
And weird connected boobs.
Yeah, boobs definitely looked like they were stitched together.
It's been bothering me since day one. Dillian Harper.
Did tons of research.
Oh, I researched the hell out of it, especially during that free week.
Yeah. Oh, what? Oh, yes. Yes, the premium week.
Yes. Oh, boy, did I learn a lot of new stuff.
Dirtbag.
Look, I can throw it on my 4K TV and not give a care.
You know, you forget about the 4K audio because I'm sure your neighbors and the children who are playing outside your window right now don't. There's the creepy man upstairs, mommy.
I haven't watched porn with the sound on in God knows how long.
Oh, I do.
I honestly don't listen to it. I'm so used to it muted. That's even in the privacy of my own home.
What can I tell you?
So, Dillian Harper against the wild card pick, the fan voted pick.
Correct.
Of a wonderfully discovered to us.
Yes, and newly addicted to.
Oh, God, yeah. Instagram person.
Personality?
Personality.
Stephanie.
Oh, if only. If only. She's the winner in our hearts.
If that was my wife, I wouldn't be on this podcast right now. You'd be talking to Chew. What? Oh, the same half podcaster.
There we go.
What happened? Your chain fell down?
Yeah, so God knows how long that's been down. And what's flown in since then.
What happened? The window's open? The screen fell?
I opened the window, but the screen comes with it, so I just have to pop it back up. But I guess I didn't pop it up all the way. Well, I found my first carpenter end of the season.
Oh, me too.
Yeah, so... apparently they're not affected.
Oh, yeah, that's right. That's part of my to-do list tomorrow, is spray the perimeter of the house.
Luckily for me, of all things, I didn't order toilet paper, but I sure ordered ant traps in time. So, those coming.
You just don't have to deal with cave crickets anymore, right?
Thank goodness. I mean, I started getting used to them. We became friends. We started having dinner and stuff. But, man, those cave crickets, pain in the ass. And it wasn't...
I threw a book at one yesterday.
It caught it, read it, and threw it back at you.
If I didn't miss him, he probably would have beat me with the book. But I got him for a shot.
And it's funny, I didn't even use the glue trap thing until like 2 months before I moved upstairs.
Yeah, they work wonders.
Years. I've been here 11 years.
That's your problem. I mean, you should have done something about that 7 years ago, but...
I'm confused.
Hello.
I was trying to process that.
You were in that basement apartment for how many fucking years?
Oh, I didn't mind it. I didn't mind it at all.
You know, you could have bought a condo, but no, you said you bought a fucking $500 Cheerio.
It wasn't $500.
How much was it?
It was between three and five, and I'll leave it at that.
Okay, but you bought a Cheerio.
I did it. Could have.
Listen. I digress, because we're going off on a tangent here. But I was thinking about this the other day when you turned 40. In 10 short years, you're going to be 50. I'm going to be 56. But you're going to be a 50-year-old man with 300 Funko Pops in your apartment.
I'll hopefully have more than that.
But what is the end game here? Like, when you're an old man and you got to be put into a home, this is Uncle Larry's pop collection. I mean, are you going to sell them? Are you going to try and make money on them? I mean, what's the end game here? And I know that you love these things, but you're a 40-year-old man now. There comes a time as a 40-year-old man, aren't you at least at that point where you want to put the toys away?
No. I bought him for a reason.
Okay, Steve Carell.
Well, you know, all right, it's maybe the Peter Pan syndrome, but, you know, it's what I like.
Keep falling back on that Peter Pan syndrome, but...
It's what it is. It's what a lot of my generation is like. Yes. Look, when our parents were in their late 30s and 40s, remember? Yeah, it was like,
they
wow.
Had deep parties.
They had what?
Key parties.
Oh, they should probably. You know, they didn't do toys or anything like that, but this is what we do. This is what I do. What do I care? It makes me happy. What do you care? It makes me happy. And
I care about you.
A, I'm not going to have enough money to be able to go into a home. B, I'm going to be found dead in whatever apartment I'm living in. So it's not really going to matter what happens with this stuff after I'm dead anyway. I don't really care what happens to it after I'm dead. So until then,
let's see
if I can get to 50 first. You know, these 10-year hurdles, they're getting rougher and rougher.
I'm going to be 46 in 4 days.
Yeah.
So I'm actually closer to 50 than I am 40.
That is true.
So,
meanwhile, we're talking about a porn star and an internet personality.
We have no chance in hell with either, but, you know.
None.
Well, I probably have more chance than... Well,
oh. A little bit. Please. Well, you do have a ring, and that really is apparently a turn-on for women.
Yeah. And a fucking burden for me. Because you don't know how many women go like, oh, you're married. Call me. And I'm like, yeah, I'm married.
Here's my room key. Hey, mailman.
Here's my WhatsApp.
Awesome. Awesome. So, yes, Dillian Hopper and Stephanie Minescu. And for the last 3 weeks, we've had on our Facebook page, Facebook.com/BetterHalfPodcast. You get to vote for the winner. And
we voted too. We're only two. So.
Exactly. So let's do this. And the winner of the 2020 March Babeness is...
The third annual March Babeness winner is...
I feel like we should have had, like, a special guest make the announcement.
With 67% of the votes.
Nice.
Oh, really? Now you're going to make me go back and do
no,
it?
No. We're good. He's busy.
Well, I would do it.
Oh!
And this is against my parole.
Are
anyway.
You dead?
So I shouldn't... With 67% of the votes, all 12 votes, 7 shares, ladies and gentlemen, or ladies, or gentlemen, or gentle them, or ma'ams. It's ma'am. The winner, without much further ado, is Stephanie Minescu, Instagram starlet.
Without further ado,
this time, if we actually message her, we will get a response.
We might. So. I'm shocked Angela White didn't say anything, but
yeah, well, she was probably getting railed.
So congratulations, Stephanie Minescu, winning the third winner. Just as she, you are the winner of the March Babeness. You caught the eye of the lonely people inside.
Okay. Don't ever sing again. You know, I hate when you sing. It, like, tears at my anus. So
good. So, so congratulations, Stephanie. We will be contacting you shortly. And you join the hallowed halls of past winners of Angela White and Leah Thompson.
And now, Stephanie Minescu.
Very
this
good.
Just I'm just bringing a tear to my eye. So,
it's very powerful.
She did good. She did good. She beat out a lot of what do you call it?
Oh, she did. I mean, when you look at that, the way the bracketing broke down, which is also on our Facebook page. I mean, it was a tournament. Just think, Dillian Hopper had to get past Kimmy Granger, Lana Rhodes, and Vanya Hadovic, who I don't know what she's doing for her country right now. Whereas Stephanie Minescu, in her first round, got past Kristen Bell with some ease. Had a little trouble with Jennifer Love Hewitt, but made it to the finals, where she narrowly... and then in the semifinals, narrowly beating out Paige Van Zandt, who currently is getting yelled at for posting those semi-nude photos on Instagram with her husband.
Hold on, I have to go check something out. Keep talking.
You know, they do like very, like Austin Powers. Remember when Austin Powers put things in front of himself and in front of what's-her-face?
Like the Angela White just posted something to the
She's congratulating Stephanie Maniscalco for winning.
She has to
crown the winner. You know,
she's only doing the same pose. I think she must have been in X-rated quarantine, but she's sitting on like her end table in different outfits, taking selfies through a mirror.
So, but, so here's I got to call this one person out. If you're an early fan of the Chip Chipperson podcast, you may remember one adult star who'd frequent the show, Alana Love. She was at the live show.
Wow, she could pick up a husband and his dick is on her neck. That's annoying.
Who, Paige VanZant?
These are very autistic.
No, they are. There's no actual nudity, but you're right. It's very artistic. They're placing items in correct places. Nothing.
Bitch boy, though.
Nothing over sexual. They're both MMA fighters, so they both got good bodies.
Fucking with them.
And, people are starting to complain that they're posing nude.
Well, they're just fucking jealous that they actually have a fucking body.
Honestly.
But wait a second. Who's taking the pictures?
I think the dog is.
Because they're both in it, and someone's taking, there's a third person there. The dog?
Maybe. Is Snoopy like taking pictures for you?
No, but I've been taking annoying videos of Snoopy, and he's getting pissed at me. He actually tried to bite me the other day.
Awesome.
I bit him back.
So, Alana Love, you know, as much as I liked her on the Chip Chipperson podcast, but if you follow her Instagram, she posts the same 7 pictures over and over again. So don't be fooled by that one.
How do you spell that name?
Alana Luv. It's porn love.
Love.
It seems like the same 6 or 7 photos.
Well, there's a couple Alana loves. It's
Alana. Alana. Alana.
Yeah, I know. But it's underscore Alana Love.
Oh, I believe so, yeah.
Official Instagram for Alana Love, let's see.
Excuse me.
Yeah, it's pretty much the same picture.
Right? That's bullshit.
Some different angles, but...
Nah. Nah.
I'm hoping to follow Ira the Weatherman's Instagram.
Sure. No, that was
I missed the chipper. Anyway, go on.
So, but no, that's basically... So, yeah, congratulations, Steffi Minescu. You will have to defend your crown all year.
Yes, yeah, send nudes. not those scratchy out ones either, so...
I'm going to stop posting those.
We'll be waiting to hear from you.
Awesome.
So, congratulations.
You are the winner.
Nope. So there's a lot of social distancing going on, but there's also a lot of social distance shaming going on.
Social distance shaming? What is that?
Oh, yeah. Well, you know, being that I am a solid suburban citizen, I'm part of some face group sites groups, Facebook groups, excuse me. You know, the local neighborhood ones. And boy, oh boy, are those mamas going nuts.
Really?
There's these mama sites. They have, like, the Massapequa Moms, the Wantle Mamas.
Yeah.
You know, they have, you know, like, the Marine Park Mom Brigade. You know, they have the Mom... The Mom Mafia. You know, it's these fucking drunk stay-at-homes who have nothing to do but bitch about helicopters and fireworks, you know? So, and like, oh, someone's cat pooped on my lawn, you know? It's like, who do I call? It's like, you call a fucking shovel and you pick it up, lady, you know? It's like, it's these fucking, it's just idiots. I'm going to read you some excerpts. From some of the recent posts,
okay,
which some that I do comment on with a nicely placed GIF or GIF, as you call it,
as it's properly called, a GIF. Yep.
But again, this is some of the. There is a lot of Like I said, a lot of busybody, shamey, twatty.
I'm curious what you mean by shaming.
I'll read you. First of all, here's the most recent post. Okay. Does anyone know of any liquor stores that deliver?
They all do now, but okay.
I was just told by a worker at Stop and Shop, Jerusalem Avenue, Belmore, that multiple employees have corona. Why are they still open? I'm not going to read you this.
The one over here? I was going to go there tomorrow.
No. Don't go to the King Cullen either.
Look, I can use another 2 weeks off.
Yeah, right. At this point, I want the fucking disease so I can just fucking die and sleep. Let's see. Oh, here's one. This woman posted this earlier today. She took a picture of the ice cream man, blasted it on social media, okay, and goes, "Here's the twisty freeze man with no mask serving our kids. No mask!" Exclamation point. Blew this fucking guy's job up, okay? Okay, so let's see. Then there's the Common Core question, and then... let's see. I see a lot of posts about the kids, and I'm doing this in my best.
Of course.
I'm not going to do the Bill Burr, oh my God, voice, but I'm going to do mine. I see a lot of posts again about the kids around town. I can't imagine that parents would still allow this. Who are you? Do you need help watching them? Are you working and forced to leave them alone? Do you need help? If you do, can you ask a family member, a friend, or neighbor? You can private message me. If there's no one else, I will do what I can do to help. Like, sure you will. I'm such a good person post that I have to let everyone know.
Oh, yeah. Know.
If it's just that you don't think it will happen to you, think again. My husband just lost one of his best friends. Parentheses, 47 years old. He leaves behind two teenagers. Well, those two teenagers are now going to be roaming the streets. Okay. Going along on that ice cream man post,
yeah.
Someone, the thing from WebMD, coronaviruses live on surfaces, you know?
Yeah.
Thing, it lives on metal for certain. So I write, how long does it live on ice cream?
Good question.
Didn't go over well.
No.
So. Let's see if I can get another one.
Have you tried to get lessons from the grandmaster of trolling?
No, he's on a level of his own, and I just sit there, and every time he opens his mouth, I just eat popcorn, because it's a master. He's just a master.
You're going to teach one of those master classes.
He's a horrible human being, but he was our friend, and I don't understand how he's married with children.
Well, I'm not going to bring anything up, but he said something the other week that was very disturbing. I was very upset by it.
I heard that, yeah. Well, we can't talk about that.
No, I know. I'm just saying. I feel bad.
Yeah, well, it happens in every marriage. So, yeah. I mean, there's times where I pretty much wanted to, I would say burn the whole house down with everyone in it. I mean, I wouldn't say that out loud or in public, but...
Hypothetically speaking...
Yeah, I mean, you know, if this was a pretend world, you know. But, so they're shaming people for letting their kids out. And, you know, look, I have kids, and they've been pretty much on lockdown. But they have to go outside. Like, you know, you can't just go in the backyard. We had them out in the front of the playing ball with Joey.
Did you have them tethered to the lawn?
Yeah, no, I had them stapled to the fence. But, I mean, they were riding their bikes up and down the street, and, you know, and there's a few of the other kids on the block were too, and I kept making sure they were 6 feet apart, you know, at least riding their bikes, you know, and when they didn't, I would take a baseball bat and throw it in their spokes. One crack skull, you're immediately the bad guy on the block.
Look, you can make it into a math lesson. You can teach them feet. You can teach them, you know, this is 6 feet.
Right.
Okay. Moving on.
No. I'm sorry. My neighbor, my friend just posted up. It's his birthday. Today, and his neighbor came out in a tiger outfit and on his lawn. It just caught my eye as he was speaking. I apologize. With a trombone. So, and actually, this is a friend of mine from college who messaged me last week. He goes, now that I'm working at home and I have no very little distractions in my office, He goes, I'm have some time to listen to podcasts. Ooh. So he goes, give me the link to your podcast. So I sent it to him, and he started listening to the episodes. I don't know how far in he is or if he just quit altogether. But I have to follow up with him on you know, yes, how he liked it. So, but yeah, we're picking up some new listeners. And very he good. Actually was, I think it was one of your friends. I don't know if it was one of your friends who's got a podcast. I think he's out of Toronto.
Oh, Lee Dickey.
Yeah.
Let's give that.
I'm sorry, I'm a child.
Let's give him a shout out, the Beats and Speaks podcast. And he just started
that podcast about? Because I don't think I don't know them. You didn't tell me about that one.
I was on that one. I talked about, actually, that's how we met in one of the chats, one of the groups. And I got on to talk about New York Comic Con. So Beats and Speaks is kind of very random. Like, he talks about a little bit of everything. It's kind of pop culture reference, where he has a new one called Yo Nostalgia, where he'll go back and he'll... They're short form. He does short form podcasts, which are sometimes good in themselves. Like a 15-minute podcast. Kind of just want to listen to something real quick and move on.
Yeah, we should do that, because ours just drag on. So we're like, all right, I hate you both. So
you would think...
One of our listeners has finished one of our podcasts.
Oh, I doubt. I can't even make it through anymore. this is why we can never start a Patreon. Just no one will ever contribute.
Yeah, pay us to go shorter.
And we're every other week. You think we should split it up like a Batman episode? But be that as it may. So again, Lee Dickey, which, by the way, happy birthday, Lee Dickey. Today is his birthday. Well, at least when we're recording. Lee
Dickey, a very special happy birthday. So
waddly doodle.
Waddly doodle.
So, yeah, so Beats and Speaks podcast and Yo Nostalgia. Lee, check those
Lee,
out.
I just want to say Lee. Oh. Lee, what a great name. Lee, greatest name ever. Lee, rhymes like B, honey. Honey, yeah. I like honey. I call my wife Melania, honey, okay?
Melania.
Greatest birthday ever, okay? You're Canadian, I get it, okay? It's cool. You have that Trudeau guy, girl, whatever, that little them, okay? Fantastically, Lee Dickey. It's a funny name. I like it.
Come on,
cool.
Okay. Mr. Trump, you know.
What?
I know you're very stressed and all, but...
I'm very stressed. Have you seen me lately? I can't get the orange applicator correct.
Okay. You've had a couple of days.
You could see where my mask is. I was very upset today. I said, you know. But can we talk 1 second before I apologize? I say happy birthday to Lee Dickey. Okay, Lee Dickey. Okay, before I say happy birthday, I just want to say, where is Crazy Eye Joe? Okay? Because if it hadn't been for Crazy Eye Joe... I would have won this election a long time ago. Where did you come from? Okay, oh, where did you go? Where did you go to Crazy Eye Joe?
Okay. How long have you been working on that, Mr. President Trump?
7 seconds ago. Literally. Okay. I'm just going to say, this is why I took 7 improv classes. Okay. I don't know anything. Okay, Larry, listen. Okay, coronavirus, bad.
Yes.
Bad. Corona beer. Not so bad. Okay, you know what? America. Buy American.
Yes.
Don't get any Canadian beer either, okay?
Oh, well.
Sissy beer.
I mean, we can't import it anyway, so it don't really matter.
They don't like us. They close their border to us, okay? Just watch. Watch the taxes we do on them. Okay, it's huge. Terrific.
Oh, boy.
Happy birthday, Dickey Lee, okay?
All right, there you go. Well, Lee Dickey, congratulations. You just got a shout-out from the President of the United States. That don't happen often.
Best president ever, 45 hours.
Oh, he's still here. Okay, there he goes. And he's out.
Where'd I go?
But no, he's still... Are you on the line? Like, are you, like, ISDN and in? Like, what are you doing?
I'm not saying that the NSA's tapped Frank Lines, but, you know, it's a distinct possibility.
I mean, yeah, I go, you know...
All the time, so I have to keep up on him.
Sir, you have a lot of work to do, sir. Just go back and continue fighting the invisible war, which we appreciate.
Bunch of Chinese bastards. Wuhan, Wuhan. Where's my fucking dumplings?
But you know, this may guarantee your win in 2020.
He left. But yeah, he's gonna win.
All right. He just disappears. I don't know. So congratulations, Lee Dickey, with a very nice shout out from the President of the United States. I've got the
Not many people get that. So
no, not at all. Actually, Lee Dickey did give us a shout out recently. Is that what you were just talking about?
That's
where we're going.
Why else would I bring it up, Larry? stay with me.
Okay? Crazy old man.
I'm dude, I have gray hairs. My hair's starting to look like Robin Williams in Jumanji, okay? I decided you should be happy. I'm going to grow my beard, my goatee. Yeah. I'm going to shave the beard, but my goatee, I'm going to go full Jim the Anvil Neidhart.
Ooh, I would love to see that.
Well, this is over. And that's until the
corona. You know what? I can kind of see a little Jim Neidhart in you. Yeah, I think so.
Yeah.
Now, if you can just get you in those singlets, we'll be good to go.
Well, I could use one of Stephanie's bathing suits. I mean, it does have flowers on it, but it's all right. Have you been reading my slow descent into...
Hold on. What's the shout-out that Lee gave us?
Oh, yeah, yeah. You're going to read it? Cause,
I do not have it in front of me.
Me neither. Thanks for the shout-out, Lee.
What was the idea? The self-checkouts. The self-checkouts.
Which, unbeknownst to me, I have to use now because of Corona. See? I went into CVS.
Got into a fight with the same guy.
When was it? It was about a week ago. I had to go in, and they had their little sneeze guard up, and he's like, yeah, self-checkout. I'm like, yeah, I don't do that. He goes, you are today, sir. All right, you 19-year-old little dick, I'll do that. And I was like, you know what, I'm going to use it today because I didn't want to touch anything. So
meanwhile, you had to touch the self-checkout.
No, I used my knuckle. And,
that's safer, yeah.
Through my hoodie.
Oh, okay, I gotcha. Okay.
Yeah, so I don't really like the way I look in this.
Oh, come on,
Here's something you can see. Look, I don't know if you can see.
Now, Jesus. Did you shave your chest?
Yeah, I'll tell you why.
Why did you shake it?
What?
Wait, what?
I'll tell you why.
Okay.
I was bored. Secondly, I was trying to shave the number 19 into my chest hair.
Why?
COVID-19.
Just okay.
Down my street, you know, topless. Going, I got the 19. But the 9 looked like a 4. So I had, because I didn't do the curve right.
Yeah.
Plus, the 9, I was afraid, I couldn't tell in the mirror if I was writing a P or a 9, because I'm apparently a moron. So just shaved the big chunk.
That is, why just shave the rest of it off so you don't get that weird patch that's just shorter than the rest of your body?
It won't. It just grows in naturally to the same length.
Oh, okay.
I control the length of my hair.
Can you really?
Look at my haircut. This is day 18 without a hair of quarantine. This is about day 29 of not having a haircut, and it hasn't grown at all.
That could be another problem.
Cancer. I mentally stopped my hair from growing.
And mostly
stopped my dick from growing too. So that, you know, it's a little.
Hey-o. This episode brought to you by Hims.
Maybe the rifle won't fuck me. But anyway.
Oh, God.
Let's see.
Oi, Gewalt. So, what?
I was saying, did you just go full Jewish on me?
A little bit. Hey, listen, if they're still allowed out to celebrate weddings and shit, I'm allowed to steal one of their words.
Yeah.
But we love our Jewish friends. We do.
Yeah, well, you know, I'm part Jew, so they got to stop getting together, though.
So. Well, didn't they? So one of the states passed a law saying that religious groups are allowed to conjugate en masse. I think.
Well. Yeah, but, I mean, seriously, they're just being selfish about it.
Of course. So. You know, it's not necessarily, this isn't necessarily a gift from God as much as it's probably a biological weapon.
You think, well, yeah, oh, absolutely. The fact that people are saying some guy ate a bat.
Oh, yeah, I've been hearing about that, yeah.
It's all Bolstein, so.
Well, AIDS was started by a guy banging a monkey.
Allegedly. It was also man-made. So.
Well, if we got through the AIDS crisis, we can get through.
I do wear a tinfoil hat, so
You are the most paranoid as far as it comes to conspiracy theories or shit like that out of anyone I know. It's amazing.
Well, I read constantly, so I'm always kind of debunking shit that I read, so I never know what's real and what's not. Sorry, I'm getting tangled up in my wires here. As you can see, my phone keeps moving.
It's the government.
Thank you for your service.
Thank you for your service.
But, yeah, like, even Jesse the Body had that, like, he had that TV show for a while.
Conspiracy.
That was about conspiracy theories. Yeah. Do you mean to tell me that FEMA is making internment camps with body bags? Yes. Unbelievable.
I ain't got time to believe. What was that line from Predator?
I ain't got time to believe.
No, the other one that someone just sent. I just learned about recently. What is it? It's you. I can't
Dylan, remember. You son of a bitch. Do you know what I caught about 5 minutes of, and it was so bad I shut it off? Sorry, my wire keeps moving.
What is going on? You keep moving. Whoa, what's going on? What was that? Was that your penis?
Penis. was it The Last American Hero or something with Arnold Schwarzenegger when he
Last Action
he
Hero.
Comes out of the movie screen? Best Last Action Hero, right? And he shoots the back of the car with the bullets, and he goes, "Not one of them worked." And I'm like, "Son of a bitch!" And I'm like, "This movie's horrible." And that's all. I just shut it off.
Get to the chopper.
And then he punches the glass, punches the window of the car to get in, and he goes, "Ow, ow!" Fucking horrible movie. But yeah, I mean, this is not the apocalypse I wanted. You know, I was kind of open for either slow moving zombies or an EMP. But
can you explain EMP for those who may not know what it is?
Electromagnetic pulse.
Thank you.
Shall I go on?
No, we're good.
Basically, it's a bomb that detonated in the atmosphere. Like a nuclear bomb, and it will short circuit anything within with a computer in it, a computer chip in it. So
what's that?
Everything with a computer chip in it. With a computer chip in it.
What's that?
Will cease to work.
Okay, gotcha. I'd be screwed at that point.
What?
I'd be screwed.
You would be screwed. Yeah, you would just be like. Up in a corner, shaking back and forth.
Right now, today's day and age, where they're trying not to spread dollar bills, I am owning the credit card only lifestyle.
Yeah, well, you know, I've been trying not to go out of my house. My wife seems to think it's okay to just go shopping, you know, for food and stuff without gloves and a mask. And I told her, she came home when I pulled the fire hose on her.
You sprayed her with it. You didn't wrap it around her, right?
Good thing. Oh, I kind of hit her over the head with a handle, but she didn't like that. The good thing about an electromagnetic pulse is that my Pontiac will drive because there's no computers in it.
There you go. All right, so you can come pick me up.
You still traffic on Jerusalem is like on a normal day. I'm never going to get to you. You could walk the mile and a half, seriously.
Well.
Take you 24 hours to walk a mile and a half, and then go on lockdown. So, but I got about a good 6 to 8 weeks of supplies before I'd have to go out and shoot my neighbors for this stuff. So,
how bad have you been with rationing your quarantine food?
Oh, I got plenty of food. I got a full freezer. And I just learned how to carve up a dog in case things get really.
How's Snoopy?
It looks pretty delicious, I'm not going to lie.
My
backyard, and he came in and he looked like, he's white, and he looked like, he's not white. he was completely covered in mud.
He was playing in the mud? Good boy.
Oh, no, he was digging. He dug a hole. He's a goddamn digger.
oh, good for him.
Yeah, goddamn diggers ruined my life.
Suck him.
Digging. I'm not thinking anything. When I came up, this is good. You'll like this. This was yesterday, as a matter of fact. Did 3 loads of laundry, filled and emptied and filled the dishwasher again.
Wow.
Okay. Helped the kids with their homeworks. Helped Joey outside. Did some work outside. Cleaned the dog after he came in covered in mud. And my wife comes upstairs from work at 5 o'clock, and she's like, really, the pots and the pans is still on the dryer, like, rack, and I'm like, what? Uh-huh. Yep. Fuck you. True story. That's a true story. She's like, it's every day. I go, every day. Yeah, I should probably go back to work and get the coronavirus.
That way you're fully quarantined from everybody.
Yeah, that's the plan. Because I said to her, because she actually said, well, if you get it, then you're living downstairs, so I'll have to move my office upstairs. And I'm not going to lie, for about a good 30 minutes in my head, I'm like, I should go to work. Someone licked me from Asia. And it happened, I'm sorry. I mean, I think my immune system is good enough that I'd be able to survive. The risk I'm willing to take to be locked in the basement with a full refrigerator, a stove, a bedroom, and all my video games, and Netflix, and DVR. I think, and porn. I think I'd be good.
Look, that's how I'm surviving.
Yeah, I think I'm going to work tomorrow.
I just ran out of food 2 days before the quarantine started, so.
Let's be honest, you didn't have fucking food in your refrigerator to begin with.
Not much.
No. Well, you're an asshole for that, because you should. All the time that Larry, I could teach you four recipes, four ingredients each, and I got this. And guess what? Now you have nothing but a bright fucking light staring at you in your refrigerator. Do you need food?
At least I have a light. Downstairs, I didn't have a fridge light.
You need food.
No, I placed an order. No, not like from the deli, so I'm getting food for the week.
Peapod?
No, the deli around the corner from me.
What do you mean you're getting food for the week?
I'm getting food.
What'd you get, like a pound of ham?
For the week.
Like a pound of ham, pound of cheese, a loaf of bread? Is that what you got?
I am getting bread. I already have some cold cuts. I'm getting some eggs. I'm getting...
You know how to make eggs?
Yeah, I know how to make... You crack the fucking thing, make sure there's not a bird in it, and you cook it.
You need scrambled eggs or soft-boiled eggs, hard-boiled eggs, omelet, eggs benedict.
They're all easy. You just crack the egg and throw it in.
No. Sunny side up, over easy, over medium.
Anything hard but boiled. Poached. Poached is disgusting.
Poached is good.
It's like you're jacking off into the water, and that's...
Like you've never done that. All of a sudden, you have standards.
I've been in a pool.
Hold on a second, I have to write a note. Do not... asterisk.
Oh, boy.
If you need food... I'm good.
I'm fine. I'm 40.
Little sweet pop, you're 40.
Little sweet. Right now, I'm surrounded by video games.
Have you caught up on anything that you've been trying to, that you've been putting off pre-Q?
A couple movies. Yesterday I watched Christopher Robin, which I liked. Actually, I liked it a lot. I'm a huge... What?
Is that the movie with Winnie the Pooh and Eeyore and Tigger?
Ewan McGregor, it's the live action. And then, he grows up, and it's basically Hook, but Winnie the Pooh.
But it's got Tiggers in it, right?
Tigger is in it, yes. Only one Tigger. Though he thinks he sees others, and he freaks out.
Thank God, only one Tigger. Because, Tiggers bounce and steal.
Well, yeah. They bounce off of steel, yes. Yes, gives them more height.
Of steel, yeah. Right, and yeah. Aluminum.
Yep.
Yeah, Rob.
Yep, so.
Rob's one of the Tiggers. Right, Robert.
So I watched that movie. I cried a little bit. And then I watched...
But he's a fag!
I brought back some childhood memories.
Oh, God.
Being fat and wanting honey and getting stuck in holes. Oh, bother. What else have I been watching?
I saw two movies.
What'd you say?
I saw Train to Busan. Did you see that movie?
No.
The zombie movie, I think, made in Korea.
Oh, I know what you're talking about. Was it good?
They're all the fast zombies.
Yeah.
And they're
was it good?
They're all they're on a train. It was very good. Yeah. Okay. Although I had to pause it 28 times because Joey kept coming in. Oh, look, Corona on TV. I'm like, Joey, stop it.
See that new show on TNT? Snow. What the hell is it called? It's like the only remaining people on Earth are on this constantly moving train, and like the Earth is like
Snowpiercer. It was
Snowpiercer. Yes.
Yeah, it was a movie.
Was it?
Yeah, you didn't see the movie. It was I forgot who was in it. The guy who was, what the hell's his name?
As if we had something to look it up with.
If only I had something. Snow. Piesa.
Oh, so they make it into a TV show. That's cool.
The other movie.
No, go ahead. I thought it's out when you're done.
The movie I saw was Onward.
Oh, because now it's direct. Is it on Disney Plus or you rented it?
It's on Disney Plus.
Okay.
And oof, that burps health.
Oh,
Chris tough. Evans. Chris Evans was in the movie Snowpiercer.
Snowpiercer. I have to check that out.
With, I believe, Ed Harris and that weird woman that looks like a man.
More specific?
And I'll tell you in a second. Tilda Swinton?
Oh, yeah, yeah.
She looks like she's one of those fucking porcelain dolls that came to life. She's a fucking weirdo.
Oh, you know, actually, yeah, I've been watching some. I watched literally almost like the first night of the quarantine when I got a message saying, like, you know, the business will be closed tomorrow. So, like, oh, okay, I guess I can stay up late. For some reason, I threw on Toy Story 4. That creeped me out a little bit with the vaudeville dolls. You know, when they're in the secondhand store, and the one girl doll, but she's like surrounded like by her like henchmen and like the old ventriloquist dolls.
Oh yeah, I don't like.
Yeah, creepy.
I didn't hear what you said.
I did say vaudeville. I apologize.
Vaudeville.
No. And then I watched Christopher Robin. So I'm catching up on a lot of stuff like that. But also what I've been watching on YouTube. Okay. No, YouTube, I'm falling down the rabbit hole again. So on YouTube, I've been watching a lot of old game shows. Like, old game shows. Like, there was, like, ones that really aren't on anymore. Like, there's this one called Jackpot. Where, basically, it was 16 contestants, 15 in the mob, if you call, and then one answering the questions, and you go back and forth, and you pick a number, and that person stands up, and, you know, if they have the jackpot, fine. If they don't, the money gets added to the jackpot. And all the answers are riddles. And they all do it the same way. You know, like, I am not the jackpot, and my riddle says this. And I can't remember the full, but it was like it was from like 1975, this particular episode. And they're like, Robin Hood's gay friends. It was the Merry Men. Robin Hood's Merry Men. But they were like, no, basically, and then they go on like a short tirade of like, making fun of gays, which back in the 70s was completely fine. And okay.
Yeah, I mean, Liberace was just a bachelor. What? Hey. Ladies can't tie him down.
So, you know, watching some of these old... I love watching old game shows for the signs of the times.
Yeah.
It, like, there was another one. It was the original High Rollers. Remember High Rollers?
Yes. Was that it had the giant dice.
Yeah, and then you had to take the numbers off the board and stuff like that.
It was craps, right? It was basically craps, right?
No. You roll the dice, and then you have to... You have to eliminate the numbers 1 through 9. And based, like, if you roll a 2 and a 4, you can get rid of a 2 and a 4, you can get rid of a 6, you know what I mean? Stuff like that. Correct. So, me and Rippo talked about it before, because it was, like, one of our favorite Commodore 64 games, High Rollers.
Yes.
But...
I remember that. I had that on Commodore 64.
Yeah, almost everyone died. It may have came packed in, I'm not sure.
It's Commodore 64.
So, this one was, like, from the late 70s, and it was hosted by Alex Trebek, with his big Canadian afro, and...
Sorry.
And he was introducing the woman who was there to actually roll it. Like, the contestants weren't allowed to roll the dice. So, they had the woman there, and as this woman's coming out, the set piece, which is kind of like a chandelier-like type thing, just bonks her on the head, just crashes on her head.
She's stupid.
No, really, Alex Trebek is like, oh.
She bumped in.
It came down early, so it kind of did like a Bret Michaels on it. And and you know, Alex Trebek is like, oh, women.
My wife was so fat. How fat was she? She was so fat, she sat on the blank. Can you imagine that show this day and age? They would never allow
That's what I'm saying. Some of these game shows. Forget about Gene Roddenberry. Not Gene Roddenberry. Gene Rayburn. He wouldn't be allowed on television.
What's his name? The one who's dead from Family Feud.
Richard Dawson.
Rich Dawson tugging down grandmas and granddaughters all in the same
family. Forget about it.
Give me a little smooch there, honey.
What about, there was another one. Well, there's the famous Canadian host.
Yeah, with the kid.
With the kid. Like, do you kiss like your mommy does?
as a daughter, as the father of a daughter, I will kill. I'm willing to go to jail and get raped by a giant man to defend my daughter's honor.
But yeah, you got to go back and watch some of these. Just these old game shows are just nuts sometimes, and some of the stuff they get away with as well is pretty funny. You know, Charles Nelson Reilly just being on television was a modern miracle back then.
How's that for a topper?
So I was watching that, and then I started. And
hey, Ruth Buzzy, you're a hot dame, aren't you?
It's a very good CNR.
Yes.
Wow, there you go.
Ruth Buzzy grabbed it on.
That's a very good CNR. So then I started falling down the rabbit hole with cow trimming. Cow hoof trimming.
You're a fucking weirdo.
No, you know, it's kind of, sometimes it's peaceful to watch.
And I'm still over restoration videos.
Yeah, some of those I'm still watching.
Go ahead.
Here's the thing. You ever just sometimes force yourself to watch something you don't want to watch?
No, because I have free spirit and free will.
So, I was going through the hoof trimming.
But the sake of the bid, sure, all the time.
I was going through the hoof trimming, and I came across, not a hoof trimming.
Sorry, I was going full opie there.
R.I.P. Vic Henley.
Yeah. He died?
He died, yeah, yesterday or today.
Oh, wow. Everyone who opie loved is dying. Vic Henley.
Yep. Someone else did.
He didn't look like he ate well. He looked like he ate like a diet of mozzarella sticks and fucking, you know, beer. Wow. So is the Opster on like full depression mode?
I think he was.
Get a gunshot to the head.
I don't know about that. Because I don't listen to podcasts, but I do follow him on Twitter.
He's muted me on Twitter.
He did. Did he block you or just mute you?
He muted me. So, because I could still see him and comment, but he never responds, and I've got some zingers in on him. Because he did something that he posted it on Instagram, and he got like 3 likes, and then he posted it on Twitter, and I go, wow, this bombed across all social media. I go, you posted the same thing on Instagram, and it sucked it too, you fucking hack. And nothing, not a single response.
That was...
And, because one time I did piss him off, he goes, consider yourself blocked, sir.
I think I saw that. Ew. I think I saw that. Real quick, because since now we're on a Twitter tangent, did OJ actually try and give advice on with the Tiger King situation?
I didn't see that, but I think it was a fake post. I could not find the tweet where he said, I think Carol Baskin did it. I saw that one, but and I'm like, I was going to write, well, we know you did it, but I'm sure that would have been everyone's response. Why am I holding
a mic? I don't know. Why are you talking into an unplugged mic?
Because I'm bored.
That's professionalism right there, 101. So anyway, so I found which I almost vomited at, a foot trimming video.
Oh, I've seen those.
Oh, and what...
I've seen it. His name is...
Not the Tobro.
Not the toe, bro? Oh,
no, but I threw up in my mouth a little bit when I clicked on, because I didn't tell what it was, but apparently when you grow older, this possibility of the heel of your foot turning into practically leather and the doctor removing the disc and about half an inch of heel with it and then just leaving this gap in the bottom of the foot.
it's basically just dead skin.
It is, but it was just like
when I was a when I was a leticaria, I would have this like buildup of dead skin on my foot, and I would have to take like a special razor.
I've seen that. No, this is
until
like
I sliced my finger open one day, and I had to get stitches. My wife threw them all away when I was at the emergency room.
This was kind of like from an alien ship, this pod descending from the rafters. Oh, it was disgusting. I immediately went back to watching a hoof.
Well, you didn't let me finish telling you what the other movie I watched.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Which was, Onward.
Yes, you did say that, yeah.
Which now on Disney Plus because it was supposed to go out in the movies, but, you know, Corona. Mm-hmm. but little advice about that movie, if you've lost your father, don't watch it.
Oh.
Because there was about two times where I had to go check the thermostat because I started tearing up with my kids. And my daughter was like, this is freaking sad. She's going, and I'm like, I know, right? And
it's a Disney movie. Of course it is.
And well, basically, it's the story is of these like magical creatures, elves and, you know, warlocks and all these things. And they slowly start to lose their magic because magic gets placed by technology. So instead of them, you know, living in little mushroom houses and, you know, using sticks, someone eventually invents the, not sticks, but like, you know,
staffs,
you know, to, you know, conjure magic. You know, things like the internet comes and, you know, cell phones, so they don't need magic. So they all, like, have to get jobs. But they're all, like, you know, like, the lizard is a dog, a pet dog, you know, the elves, one guy works construction, you know, the other one's, like, the mailman, you know. But this one wizard, these two kids, teenagers, their dad dies, and one kid is obsessed with, you know, magic, but he's, like, a, you know, stoner, and the other kid's, like, a, you know,
nerd.
Weak. You know, he's weak. He's like, you know, he's a nerd, you know, and he's a weak pants kind of thing. They
it's
find
like
this spell. Pretty much. Yeah. No. But they pretty much find this spell where they can bring their dead dad back for one day.
Oh.
Yeah. But it only gets from sunrise to sunset. From sunset to sunset. So.
Oh, okay.
So, of course, the spell gets screwed up. And they only bring him back from the waist down. So they have to go on a quest to find this stone that will help them, you know, get the rest of his body back so they could spend whatever time remaining they have of the 24 hours with him.
Mm-hmm.
And they go on a quest. They grow as brothers. There's a few heart-to-hearts. There's a few, you know, me crying on the couch. Man, I was like, my daughter goes, "You okay, Daddy?" And I'm like, "I miss my father." Shut up. Like, miss Grandpa. So then my son, who has the heart of an angel, my daughter has the heart of Charles Manson. My heart of Mother Teresa. My son kind of goes, he goes, "Daddy, are you sad?" I go, "Yeah, Joe, I'm a little sad." I go, "I miss my father." I go, you know, how would you feel if, you know, Daddy wasn't here anymore? And my daughter, of course, with her wise mouth, goes, "Well, you wouldn't be farting all the time." You know, and my son goes immediately sad face and comes over and gives me a hug.
Aww.
And I look at my daughter, I go, "You're a miserable child."
Just give her the finger.
I pod for a day. So,
Aww, adorable.
It was a rough movie, but I'm trying to catch up on my DVR. I've been catching up on some Netflix, but again, I have to stop it 32 times, you know. But the good thing is Sunday mornings, since I am the teacher from Monday to Friday, Saturday mornings, my wife pretty much is like, I wake up, I have breakfast, and then I go downstairs and I hide till lunch.
That sounds good.
Yeah, and I just sit there and watch TV or play video games.
Just stare at the wall.
I'm actually playing NHL 20 on PlayStation 4, and there's a, you know, be a pro mode where you can create your character and your likeness. So I got into two fights in one game, and I broke my nose.
Nice.
And then I was out for 22 days.
Wow. That sounds like a long...
simulate the games. I couldn't even play them. They're like, you can't play the games, you have to simulate them. I'm like, I couldn't play enough. I'm like, wow, that sucks. And I'm like, first of all, no hockey play would be out for the 22
days. Yeah, that's a long, yeah.
Minutes. And in those 22 days, which turned out to be like 15 games, my team went 2-13. So
there you go. So you are the strong link of the team.
Well, I do lead the team in goals, assist points, hits, and penalty minutes. So awesome. I got that going for me. But the good thing is, though, without hockey in real life, I'm actually catching up on regular time.
Oh. And then, of course, for me, I got to say, probably the highlight of the quarantine for me, since we're talking slightly...
talk about this?
About video games. Well, I want to go into a little more in-depth with the four of us, and I want to do that on Retro Gamers, but we can talk about it here, because I don't think anyone's listening by this point.
Yes, appear on Retro Gamers with that. So.
Yes, absolutely. And I'm sure everyone's already...
warrant. They're not going to...
Everyone's already tuned out by this point.
yeah. What would it be, like an hour and 10 or any?
Hour 25.
That was close.
So we finally, as a squad, the four of us finally got the W in a little game called Player Unknown's Battleground.
Winner, winner, chicken dinner.
PUBG.
Just a little history. I did get a solo win a year ago. Yesterday? Or 2 days ago?
No, only like a couple of days after me, I think.
It's like April 5th of last year, or something like that. Now this game is one of those battle royale games. It's 100 people jump out of a plane. You land on an island with nothing on you except
every
your clothes,
man or squad for themselves,
or not. And then you have to loot and find guns and mm-hmm. backpacks, and helmets, and vests, and then you basically could get 1 kills or 99 kills. You have to just be the last man standing.
Yeah,
like I got one in 3 years of playing. I got one solo kill, one solo win, no squad, no duos. And then Eric, who we play with...
who I think created the game.
Has never gotten a solo win, but has gotten like two or three squad wins with strangers.
there you go.
Still cannot confirm. But he also has a ton of mobile PUBG mobile wins, but we don't count those.
Yeah, mobile game is easier, but yeah.
And then
actually, I think I won on mobile.
I never won mobile because for some reason I can't get it downloaded onto my.
It's all right. It's.
I did download a similar game, and I didn't like the
control. Yeah, it's weird. Yeah, you're right.
On the flat screen. So.
And then our fourth. God. You were talking about our fourth.
To our dirtbag fans, follow bang.com. Bang. _com_ on Instagram. Sweet right. Jesus.
Check that out anyway, while you're talking.
Yes, check out the one with the red boots. Anyway, so the other night, the four of us were playing as a squad, which we've been doing a lot in this quarantine thing, which is kind of nice because we get to hang out with our friends even though we can't hang out.
And what I want to say is leading up to this, in all seriousness, you know, this whole quarantine, the whole virus was really getting to me. Like, seriously getting to me. Like, not to the point that I'm going to, jump out the window and hang myself, but it was really, I was deeply depressed, more than usual. And so I needed something. I needed some sort of outlet. And what eventually happened with this was exactly what I was looking for.
Because you canceled your party. You know, your big...
it was a little bit of everything. Yeah, it was a little
bit
of...
I'm not going to lie to you. I'm kind of getting a little... I don't want to say PTSD because I don't want to disrespect our military.
No,
like
but
you've seen that term.
PTSD is not just for military. Good Lord.
Yeah.
Holy
but,
moly.
I've had moments of depression.
Yeah.
Like, I'm going through, like, a range of emotions. And, yeah, I'm very grateful that I still have income coming in. Some people don't. Mm-hmm. None of my family, thank God, is sick. I do know one person that died and a few others who are sick. But it's starting to get to me. I for someone who's always wants to break out of his rut, I long for the status quo. I long for the normalcy of what we were a month ago, a month and a half ago. You know, the fact that I had to wait online today to go into a supermarket that I would go into at any given moment, you know, is it bothered me, mm-hmm. you know? I mean, and that's the first time, because normally up until about, I mean, I haven't gone out of my house in about 4 days, but with the exception of the front lawn or just to walk around the corner, but I haven't gone to any stores or anything. That was the first time I had to wait, and I was like, this sucks. And I'm like, and first of all, I'm not okay. We don't get political, but if you're going to vote for Bernie Sanders, that's exactly what you're going to get. So feel that burn, bitch, because you're waiting online for fucking bread. but that's about enough of that. So go on. I'm sorry. I didn't mean
No. It's part of what was happening. So, yeah, so I was really just feeling shitty, and so we were playing the game. I was like, all right, you know, I'll join, because I don't always play because it's so fucking late when you guys play, and I'm already in bed.
In the bed, except Birdie, whose kids were up at like, you know,
honestly.
Go to bed.
Fine, do whatever you want.
Go to bed.
So I was on, in the four of us, and we played a few games actually leading up to this. So then now we're playing this epic game, and what happens is basically we get to the end, and it's just me, Verdi,
right.
Eric.
We got split up from the beginning.
We always do.
So it was me and Verdi, you and Eric. Verdi and I, we met up with a team. I killed one. The guy knocked me, I knocked him. I killed one, knocked the other. The other guy healed him, and then I got killed, and Verdi got killed.
Yeah.
And so now it's you and Eric. And you... decide to take a motorcycle into the final circle.
I did. I did.
Which I believe got Eric killed because you were just driving next to him nice and slow.
Right? No, I don't think so. That's not true.
I kind of do. But I've been playing a lot longer than you. But you were the one got me addicted.
Excuse me. Okay.
But by the motorcycle in the final circle, you're kind of giving away your location. But anyway, whatever. I digress. Eric gets the kill. Larry has to swim across the water to get into this little tiny like area, which we've actually never been to on the map.
Yeah, it was kind of new, yeah.
And then, Larry, I'll let you finish your story.
Like, I just basically, you know, at that point, and what happens is the game keeps shrinking. The level, the fighting level keeps shrinking and shrinking and shrinking. And I was just, now I'm just camped out in this house. I just happen to be in the middle of the zone. And I'm just staying. I'm like, you know what? I'm going to stay here for as long as possible. Because whenever someone gets killed, it comes up on the screen. You can see it, like who killed who.
So went down to about, what, 15 people, I think it was?
Just about. I'm actually trying to find the actual game right now. I'm having a little trouble finding it. So now it's down to, like, 4. And then it's down to 2, and the screen shrinks again.
You missed a very important part where there was explosions going all around him, gunfire all around him, and the three of us are spectating you, and we're watching the number go 15, 14, 13. And then a door opens in Larry's house that Larry's in. And I'm like, he's coming in your house. I go, Larry, the second that door opens, you start shooting. And then the best part about it is Larry has two of the worst guns in the game to go to the final two with. And he's got a automatic shotgun, but which is actually very good in close quarters.
Very
when
good.
You're out
yep.
on, you need like something like Eric uses the sniper rifle. I use ARs. Mm-hmm. You know, Vert uses whatever he could find. Because he hasn't found the gun that he likes yet. But my gun of choice is the AKM. I just checked. I have 58 kills with an AKM.
Nice.
Yeah. So anyway, we hear the guy coming upstairs, and the door opens, and the guy just stares at you. And then we're like, shout! Larry!
So I fire square in the face. Wait, that was the guy who came in through the door?
Yeah,
I'm sorry, yeah. So, yeah, killed him, and I kind of ran back in, and I'm like, and then it shrinks down again. So I'm like, oh, shit, I got to go. So I jump out the window.
You got him on the staircase.
I did, yeah.
And then I said, so wait. Now, here's what I would have done. Now, granted, I will never criticize your game again, but I would have took his gun. No, not Larry. Larry stays with the shotgun and the
witchcraft. Because here's my mentality. I'm panicking throughout the whole situation. I'm not good enough or quick enough to start switching things around on the fly like that. So I'm like, I, for all intents and purposes, I was just trying to figure out when and where this guy was going to kill me, and I would get, we would get second place. Right. So I jump out the window, and I make
zone closed.
Yep, and I made the turn. Did apparently.
Wait, that again. You're not building up the dramatic. For someone who loves to tell stories, you're horrible. He goes, we're watching the number go at 9, then now it's 7, then it's 5, and then it's 4. And then all of a sudden, it was at 5, and all of a sudden we just hear like an explosion and a bunch of machine guns, and now it's 2.
And all I hear, and I'm now, be 100% honest with me. How much
me?
Faith, yeah, you. How much faith did you have that I was going to be able to pull that off? To get the win.
Well, because the guy who...
well, we don't know who the guy is yet.
Don't know, but I knew you were in a good position because you were on the second floor. What bothered me the most was that there was a boost right there that you could have taken.
I know, that bothered a lot of people.
Because you had like 3/4 power energy. You could have literally had... you could have went to full by the time you did it, but you walked right past it and didn't take it. But I had little faith because I knew you haven't played a lot, mm-hmm. and I don't think you've gotten many number two spots.
Tell you in a few seconds, but continue.
But we were all spectating and kind of not. We would know like do this, do that, do this, and then the zone.
I was getting some help.
Now, Larry's half of his house is in the zone. Half of the house is not in the zone. Now if you're in the bad part of the zone, you start to lose energy.
Speaking of which, I just want to say, and I could have sworn I did at some point, I did not heal at all during this game.
I don't know.
No. I'm looking at PUBG Lookup. I did not heal at all during this scene, which I thought I did. So now it's down to two people. Me, and I will give credit where credit is due, Ghost of Drift 13, who might have had the most... No, he was tied for the most kills in this particular game. Him and one other person had 7 kills. Who was the other person? Out of curiosity, what was this? Spawncraft was the other person. So Ghost of Drift 13. So I come out of the... I jump out the window, and I circle around to the back of the house. And then all of a sudden, pop, pop, pop. I'm like, oh, shit, I'm getting shot. So now I figured...
Larry's in, like, an alleyway, and the guy's in a building.
Oh, yeah, I'm wide open. Yeah. I'm
so
a sitting
Larry
duck.
Gets a shot off, misses. You did miss.
No, I did, okay? Yeah. And then
he hit you. Now you're in the red. You had very little power.
Yeah, so here's... You know, my mindset is like, well, he's shooting me. This guy's a pro. And it's just a matter of, you know, how am I going to screw this up? If I had used any other weapon, it would have taken me too long to reload. And I would have shot all over the place, and it would have been terrible. But because I had the shotgun, he shoots. Frank is screaming in my ear. He's reloading. Move in.
I was like, get him, he's reloading, this is your shot.
I circle around, we meet in the door, and it was as if we stared each other in the eyes, and we went, this is it. One of us will have to meet our destination, and the other one will live on in glory. And whereas Ghost of Drift 13 probably thought, fuck this guy, let me kill him, let me get another win. And... he must have ducked or bent down to do something, because I shot that shotgun. It was the only headshot I got in the game, and it was with him. And you, then...
You did not duck. You aimed high. if you probably aimed an inch over, you would have missed him. But you aimed high, and he probably had half energy, and he had just finished reloading. And you took that headshot, and...
So here's the thing.
Literally inches between each other.
Yeah. I shoot him. But, like, it doesn't immediately end. So I shoot him, and then there's a silence on... Because there's only the four of us on the chat. We can only hear the four of us. And there's just silence. And it's kind of like, wait, what? Hold on. And then, like, 4 seconds later, it pops up. Even. Winner, winner, chicken dinner. And...
But we were screaming.
I wish that recorded.
I woke my whole family.
Yeah. I've played 234 career games. I've won once. I've top 10 43 times. I only have 34 kills, 8 headshots. My winning percentage is 0.43.
It's actually not bad, considering, you know.
And,
are you looking at your lifetime stats?
I was looking at my lifetime. Oh, and just for fun,
let's
see.
Are you talking on squad, though, or?
No. Lifetime.
Okay.
Yeah, because there was a couple of top tens. I came in second in a solo once. And I didn't shoot once. I just kept hiding the entire game. Now, that particular game lasted 30-something minutes, about 32 minutes. Here are some of the other games that I've played, how long I've lasted before I was killed. 6 minutes. 3 minutes. 2 minutes. 3 minutes. Oh, 1:52. That was a long one. A couple of 7-minute games. All right, 12-minute game, a 20-minute game. All right, so there's some good stuff there. So I'm not, that prolific with this, but you know, I do what I got to do.
Just the comparison between mine and yours. Now, how many career total matches have you had?
When I say 234,
you don't have it in front of you, or you?
I just switch to a different screen.
Okay, this is how hard this game is. I have 1,454 career total matches.
There you go.
I have 254 top tens, 86 headshots. Headshot kills, 375 kills, and 2 wins. And 1 win, I was dead, because that was your win. So I guess because we got the squad and 1 solo.
Yeah.
But the game is ridiculous. It's basically Fortnite for adults.
Basically, yeah.
Known as that building shit, you know, but and, you know, creating bridges and bullshit.
That's what I hate about that one, yeah. But that we can talk about on the better the Retro Gamers.
Yeah, next time I would definitely, you know, get me involved with that. I would love to talk about it.
I'll get you guys all on it.
And the best is, 5 minutes before this ending, I'm yelling at Larry. It's like, he's like, Larry goes, I'm sorry, who's dead and who's alive? I'm like, shut up and get 46 kills or whatever it was. I'm like, get rid of that gun. I go, just do what I tell you to do, and I'll get you through the room. And you're like, shut up. And I was like, And then I actually felt bad because I said something that I kind of regret saying. I was like, if he wins this with a shotgun, I'm going to kill myself.
I don't care.
But I was like, but I was so happy for you because when I won my solo, I was by myself. And I was like, in the basement going. And I had to take a picture of it because I was like, no one's going to believe me. And this is before website.
I think
I keep your stats.
All of you texted me a picture of the screen.
So, the next morning I get and I tell Stephanie and she's like, yeah, I don't care.
Well, no, she yelled at you.
She yelled at me. She's like, you were really loud last night. You woke us all up. And I'm like, Larry won his first win and we all got the win because she goes, yeah, but you were really loud.
You and your friends.
You and your friends with your boyfriends hanging out playing video games. Sorry.
Oh, boy. Oh, well. Well, with that, I think probably we should start to wrap this one up.
Correct.
Oh, also, I should have mentioned this earlier because now no one is listening. Frank is now 2-0 on quiz nights. Fucking pulled it out of his ass again.
Get accused of cheating, and I don't appreciate that.
Did you? By who? Me? Did I accuse you? I may have accused
you. My mic. Yeah, the mic from our show when we did
last time we did trivia night.
Last time we did trivia
before quarantine.
Zoom trivia night, 80s trivia night, which was cool.
Very cool. I had very fun time.
The monotony of this quarantine.
Yeah.
Although the one fucking guy from Philly was giving me shit. I'll fucking you bold bastard.
Honestly.
I was looking at, you know, talking very shit about the Rangers. Last time I checked, you guys haven't won anything in 45 years.
I loved it at the end of the night, though. I guess the guy from Philly.
I let's be honest. Look, I won by 1 point, but
did you? You did. Yeah. Hey, listen, a win.
But then I was like, yes. So once again, New York beats Philly, and I logged off.
No, something happened. Like his kid came out. I guess did something off camera, and he was ripping into him. Then all of a sudden, looks at his wife and goes, "Are we muted? Mute that." And then he just goes muted, and then you see him turn back and just thought...
Oh, that's okay. When I went, when I ripped into my kids the other night, I immediately had to go shut every window and door in the house. I'll probably be going to jail tomorrow. So. Those kids will be nuts. So,
alrighty, Frank, we're gonna get out of this quarantine soon enough, and we'll be able to get back together to finally record again as one.
Yes.
Excellent.
Excellent.
All right.
I like the cut of your jib, Larry.
And I'm gonna leave you with this. Lawrence of Arabia, he's an English guy. He came to fight the Turkish. Meep, meep.